All right, welcome everyone. Today we're going to learn how to use NightwatchJS globals to keep your tests maintainable and allow for reuse across multiple environments. Using global variables instead of hard-coded values in your tests will allow you to reuse your existing tests against different environments like development, sandbox, and production. This is because the tests become more data-driven in a way because the test values are read out of a config file instead of hard-coded to your test. You'll also find that under this approach, the tests become more maintainable. For example, if the product adds support for localization or translations, you don't need to waste time finding and updating values across your entire test suite. You only need to make the change in one place, your configuration file. So in today's tutorial, I'll be using an example from my GitHub that I'll link in my video description down below so that you can follow along. Please feel free to pause this video at any time to test the like button above the video description by giving that a click to make sure it isn't broken. So let's get started. All right, so now we're here at my GitHub. So the first thing we need to do is get the code. So let's click on the code button here and get my clone URL, copy that to the clipboard, and then we can go ahead and check that out somewhere convenient. Now that we have the clone URL, we can type in git clone and bring in the code. And for this tutorial, we'll be working out of the environment variables directory. So here we are on screen at that location. So I'm going to right click and say to open up brackets project because that's the IDE I'll be using. VS Code also works pretty good in this case. All right, so now that we have the source code of the tutorial, we can launch the sample web app that we'll be writing our tests against. So from our command line down below, under the Nightwatch Tutorials environment variables directory, we can type in npm run dev. And that's going to launch NodeMon. So if we open up a browser and go to localhost 3000, we should now see the Really Mellow Shirt Company dev login. So we are running in development mode. So we'll be using this really simple web app to demonstrate how to reuse your tests between dev and production modes. So let's just really quickly go through the app. It's a very simple web app with a login screen and a profile page. So in development mode, it has a password of Nightwatch and password. If we sign in, it shows the user's name, their shirt size preference, and their favorite website. So now that you've seen this web application, let's write some very basic tests that we'll refactor later to use global variables. All right, so we're gonna get started here with the before each test hook, and this before each test hook gets executed before each test runs. So inside here, we're gonna put our navigation logic. So to navigate to our page, we're gonna type in browser.page.login.navigate. And once we've navigated to the login page, we're going to log in as our username, which was Nightwatch, and password, which was password. So that takes care of the before each test logic. And now for after, we just type after, same sort of format, function browser. And then here, all we have to do is end the test. Now that we have those two test hooks out of the way, let's write our first test case. Let's make sure that the correct name appears on the profile page. So sometimes what I like to do in tests that follow the login method is verify that I've landed where I think I'm supposed to be. So in this case down below, if you've noticed, I've added this assertion here that the browser page profile, I'm expecting that the page title text ends with Really Mellow Shirt Company Dev User Profile. So that's essentially the main header title of the profile page. So if I'm still on the login page, it would differ. Now that I know I've been correctly redirected to the profile page, we can write a test assertion here to make sure that the correct name shows up. So let's go to browser.page.profile, and we're going to expect the name element .text to equal Jana Leftis. All right, so we can save that. So let's test out what we've written so far. So in a command window, let's type in nightwatch-t and test/before.js. So let's run that. All right, so two assertions passed. Let's write another test. So to speed things up, I've done a little bit off camera. So let's take a look at this next test. It's called correct t-shirt size preferences displayed. So again, given that I'm on the profile page, I want to expect that the page title, again, is user profile, and that the shirt size displaying for the Jana Leftis user is large. So again, let's rerun the test, and that's going to be the before file once more. Browser opens and quickly goes through. So now we have four total assertions passed. We verified that the shirt size is large and that the correct name appears on the profile page. Perfect. So now we have a fully working test suite for our application, but what happens when we want to test in production or some other environment that maybe has different data, maybe different users? What if in the future the product adds translations, for example, and now large is now Largo? Well, then what do you do then? Do you have to duplicate all of your tests and waste time? So instead, what you can do is write your tests with variables. And inside the Nightwatch configuration file, there's a global collection that you can pass around inside of your tests so that if any of the data does change, you can do it in just that one place, similar to how page objects work, where if you need to refactor, it's all centralized in one particular file, and it saves you a lot of time. An advantage of the Nightwatch Test Globals collection is that they can be tied to your environments. So you can specify the environment when you run your test, and then it will pick up the test values specific to that environment so that your test passed. So let's see how that's done now. So first, let's take a look at our before file and see what our opportunities are for variables. All right, so first off, anything that's a string is typically something that you'll want to refactor to use variables. Especially in the case of logins, you're not going to want to save those and commit those in your source code. It's going to drive the security team nuts. So having things like your password in here is bad. You're going to want to either put that in a config file or an environment file that you don't commit to your source code, or you put that in something like a system variable. So basically any strings or values that are hard-coded in your test that could be dynamic in the future, you're going to want to break out into the Nightwatch config file. So let's take a look at that now. Let's open up NightwatchJSON. And down under test settings, you'll notice here that I have dev and production. And within those, I have this globals collection. And this is where you're going to want to put all of your dynamic test data. So you can access these with dot notation. So here's the company name, and you notice that it's just really Miller Shirt Company with dev on the end. The username and password I have set in here. So we're going to take those out of the test itself. And if you don't even want to store the password in the configuration file, you can read it out of a system environment variable as well using notation like this. But for this example, we'll leave it in here. Something you'll probably find very useful on larger projects is grouping your variables together under sub-objects. So for example, I store everything that I'm going to need for the profile page under profile here, and that prevents naming collisions as your project gets larger. And you might have variables that have common names like name, for example, right? You know that the name here is specifically for the profile page, and if you have a different one elsewhere in the product, you know it's for somewhere else. And now down here under production, we have the same keys, but different values in them. So now let's open up after.js and see how it's been refactored to use global test variables. So starting with the before each method, you'll notice that the login as doesn't have the fixed strings of Nightwatch and password. We're going to browser.globals.username, which is just finding the value out of the NightwatchJSON file under browser.globals.username. And same thing for the password. We're going to get that out of browser.globals.password. So that's much better than storing that inside of the test and gives you the flexibility of reusing that across different environments where there might be different users and different passwords. All right, so that takes care of the before each hook. Now let's take a look at the actual tests themselves. So starting with the correct name appears on the user profile page, we're using a bit of string interpolation here. So we're going to browser.globals, then getting the company name out of there. And then we're just tacking on user profile because in this case, we know that user profile will always remain static. The only thing dynamic about that code is that the company name could change. So that's one approach there, but you could also change the approach to use this entire string inside your configuration if that's something you prefer. And lastly, down here for the name that appears on the profile page, here's the example where I'm saying that we're drilling a little bit further with the dot notation into a sub object called profile, which stores things specific to the profile page. So in this case, profile.name. And then lastly, a very similar pattern we're showing for the correct t-shirt size preference is displayed test. Again, the same assertion as before. And then for the shirt size, we're drilling into browser globals profile shirt size. So let's see how that runs. So now instead of running the before.js file, we're going to run after.js. And we're also going to pass the environment flag, in this case dev, because that's what our test app is set up to run as right now. And let's try this. So by passing this dev environment flag, it was able to pick up the correct values from our test file. And just to show you how that's going to fail now, if we were to use that for a different environment, let's run under production. See, invalid username or password. So in this case, since I told the environment flag that we were in production, it used the production credentials instead of the development ones, which caused our login to fail. So the test failed when it tried to verify that we were on the user profile page because it didn't advance from login. Now to tie everything together, to show that the test can also run against the production instance, I'm going to relaunch the web app in production mode. So to do that, I need to find the command window. And if I do npm start, it's going to relaunch our web app now. And now you'll notice that this is not the dev login page anymore. This is the production page. And so to log in, I'd have to change the credentials from Nightwatch password to Nightwatch test automation. You'll also notice now that the customer's name has changed to Anita Showstopper and the shirt size has changed to extra large. And she too enjoys davidmelo.com. I bet there's a lot of really good information there. All right, so let's get this out of the way and rerun our test. Okay, so again, we can keep the after.js file and the production flag. Let's rerun and see what happens. So again, four assertions passed, but this time it ran against production with the production values. Here you can see it was checking for extra large and a Anita Showstopper for the user, and it was all in sync. And I hope you could see how powerful this could be with larger test suites. So definitely give this a try and let me know if this tutorial helped you write more reusable or maintainable test automation. I'll be posting more test automation tutorials to my channel, so be sure to subscribe to be notified. And as always, thanks for watching.